Project interviewed 24 refugees who now live in Austin. In their words, this is their migration experience.
Yeah, surprising part was to see that there are people who do know who's a refugee compared to what is happening around the world. There are people, when you say refugee, to them they understand that they are just people who are running away from their country instead of staying in their country and they build their country, and they are coming to eat up our tax. But that is not really not the truth. And the truth is that refugee is someone who's displaced. They cannot go to their home country because of some reasons, such as civil war, persecution, genocide, religion, due to their religion or affiliation of some other political individuals. What I would like to let Americans know about refugees, that refugees, they are vulnerable people who are not able to go back to their home countries because of some different reasons for each individual, or depending on where they came from also. But refugees, they are very talented people. They are not just there as a cost. They're also there as a contributor in the society. They pay tax, they are business people.
There is a joy the refugees feel when they first arrive in the United States. Austin, notably, extends a warm welcome. Warmer still, because refugees have never been welcomed anywhere. Their new community is full of surprises.
People are amazing, and especially people in Austin, very helpful. And if you seek help, they will help you without any hesitation. Many organizations helped me. Austin is my home right now, I could call it, because Austin, I love Austin. I travel, I go to the other states, and to be honest, I just want to go back to Austin. The people in Austin, they are amazing.
كان حلم حلو انه اجي على اوستن واوستن كثير حلوه وماكو يعني فرق بينها وبين العراق لانه هم الجو كثير حار بس هي حلوه وخضراء وجوها كثير حلو واحنا مبسوطين كثير قاعدين هون.
When I came here I was surprised by the nature because it was so beautiful, you know, everything is so green. We do have trees in Iraq and stuff, but like here there's more nature. And I love it.
It was kind of overwhelming, but on my arrival, it was in the night. I couldn't see anything. And I heard there was a team of volunteers that volunteered to welcome us. Some we spoke the same language and some they were Americans. It was a joyful moment to meet, see that there are people who are ready to welcome us in the city.
Probably like everyone had their own desk and chairs. Well, everyone had their own chairs and probably like their own books that they did not have to share. You could break a pencil and get a new one. You could sharpen it, you could erase it. You could get a book. I mean, it's not that we didn't have books. It's just that fancy things, when you come here, you say that, whoa, this is fancy, because you didn't see that before.
خیلی مهربان، انسان‌های خیلی چه بگویم با احترامی پیدا کردیم با اطفال و خصوص، چون در کشور ما یگانه قشری که مورد تحقیر و به نظر کم دیده میشه اطفال ما است که توجه ندارن، به جز از اعضای فامیل و خانوادش که مهربانی میکنن دیگه از بیرون کسی نه، یعنی مورد مهربانی و لطف قرار نمیگیرن. ایجا که آمدیم به هر جایی، اگر مثلا شفاخانه رفتیم، مارکت یا شهر و بازار، هر جایی که بود، طفلای ما یک قسم خوش می شدن وقتی با یکی روبرو می شدن، چون امو چهره خندان یارا می دیدن و برشان لطف و مهربانی داشتن. یعنی در کل خود راحت احساس می کردیم وقتی عادت کردیم با محیط، وقتی با مردم دید و برخواست داشتیم.
What's surprising me that you all drink coffee in a big cup. And I went to the organization and said, do you want a coffee? I said, sure. and he brought me looks like a bowl cup. Like I say, this is coffee or water? He said, no, it's coffee. I said, oh my goodness, an hour cup in Arabic, like just two sip. That was the most surprising for me.
Soon, however, limitations, particularly in language and finances, become obvious.
You know, you start from the zero, and then it's hard. Like, you know, if you move from location to location, from apartment to apartment, it is very hard on people. So how about you moving from country to country, crossing like seven oceans, and you don't speak the language, you don't know anything. This is must be very difficult, and that was difficult for me, you know, to start like the new life, and challenging at the same time because of my disability.
एकदमै गाह्रो कुरा भनेको अब जीवन राम्रो भन्नुलाई हजुर पढाइ अब हामीले सानोमा अब पढिएन अब ठुलो भएपछि अहिले अब आएर पढ्दाखेरि एकदमै गाह्रो सानो अब कलिलो दिमागदेखि पढेर आएको भए चाहिँ अब हामीलाई धेरै सजिलो हुन्थ्यो होला अहिलेको यो अब मान्छे अब बुढो भएपछि बुढो दिमाग पनि बुढोै हुँदो रहेछ क्या हो अब पढ्न आउँदैन त्यही चाहिँ एकदमै गाह्रो भाषा
बुझेकै छैन ဟိုကားရိုက်ဆူအင်းဖိုးရဘလိုပြောမလဲဆိုကိုအနေအတကပေးရတယ်ဆိုတော့ပေးဖို့ရကိုကနားလေးပါတယ်လို့ပြီးလို့ဆိုရှင်ဘောနော်ဒီမှာကျတော့ဘာမှမဆိုအကျွေးနဲ့တွားနေရတယ်ဆိုတော့မလို့အပ်တဲ့ကားရီဆိုရင်မရှိမဖြစ်အကျွေးနဲ့ယူရတယ်ဘောနော်အဲ့လိုဒီဘာမှမဆိုအကျွေးနဲ့ယူတဲ့အခါကျတော့လာဆင်ပေးမန့်အကျတော့ကိုကနည်းနည်းကိုလာစာနဲ့လောက်ပါမလား
الصعوبة
هي اللغة كانت بالنسبة لنا يعني ومعلومات كثيرة بوقت قصير لازم نتعلمها على السريع يعني معلومات تخص الحياة اليومية شلون ندفع مثلا الأجار شلون ندفع الفواتير شلون نتسوق أو فتح حساب البنك هذا كله كان يعني جديد علينا ومحتاج وقت حتى نتعلمه بأسرع وقت لأن نحتاجه يوميا فأعتقد هذه كانت الصعوبة بالبداية
I would say the first thing is language. Language is the key to understand, communicate with people. That's the key. How are you going to communicate with people? Even though everything was hard, but other things, you know, you can be adapted and comfortable by time. But the language at the first time is challenging, you know. Even if you know the questions and like if they ask me questions and you know the answers already, you try to answer them, but you struggle with the language, so you're like, okay, I'm gonna be quiet.
And then culture shock. They start to feel disoriented by experiencing unfamiliar ways and attitudes that they had not prepared for.
طبعا هو ماكو يعني شيء انه كله اوكي يعني في شغلات هم ما منيحة يعني مثلا تحس انه الاطفال من عمر 16 بيكون شوي يستقل عن نفسه فانا بالنسبة لي يعني بحب الاولاد كلهم يكونوا جنب يعني بالبيت تحت رعايتنا هنا بامريكا من 16 سنة يعني بتحسي انه بده يشتغل و بده يستقل او 18 سنه بده يطلع من البيت او هيك شيء هذا اللي ما حبيته هنا بدي العائله تضل يعني كلها متجمعه بمكان واحد
هسه ابا نيا جيبن شروع गर्न लागि अब किनभने आफ्नो र अर्काको देशमा अलिकति कल्चर फरक छ अनि आफ्नो भोलि चाहिँ आफ्नो बालबच्चाहरु आफ्नो किनभने आफ्नो नेपाली कल्चरहरु बिर्सिलान भन्ने त्य अलिकति डर लाग्छ अनि भोलि चाहिँ अब खै कस्तो हुने आफ्नो चाहिँ नेपाल कल्चर अनुसार चाहिँ त्यही भनिन्छ तर यिनीहरू चाहिँ आफ्नो कल्चर बिर्सिन्छन् कि भनेर त्यही अलिक डर लाग्छ दुःख लाग्छ
Though often devout practitioners of their faith, refugees come from countries where the dominant faith is practiced fully and minorities are persecuted for their differences. The US is a new experience.
بلادنا انه نسمع كان صوت الاذان يعني خمس مرات باليوم
The challenges that I faced in practicing Islam here it's hard to find people who practice my religion let alone my sect so I'm Shia and we are like a minority of Muslims. So it's very hard to, you know, find those people. I don't take Eids off, which is very hard. Again, it makes me feel like, yet again, like an outsider in my faith, because I don't really get to practice these things. I feel weird if I ask to take the day off, because I feel like they wouldn't understand. So I'm like, okay, might as well work. Like, we're not going to be doing anything.
ما أتذكر إنه أحد ضايقني أو يعني حسسني إنه حجابي هو مشكلة. ما عدا بالبداية أول ما وصلت الأمريكا إنه قدمت على شغل بمطعم كان. فبالمقابلة إجاني الرفض مباشرة. يعني بعد ما شافوا حجابي يعني كنت لابسة يعني درس طويل فستان طويل. فإجاني الرفض إنه ملابسك مو مناسبة للعمل. أما عدا ذلك لا الحمد لله يعني الناس حتى مثل يسألوني أنت منين مثلا أو مثل حجابك حلو فدائما التعليقات كانت إيجابية والحمد لله والشكر.
The opposite of that. So چهره کاملا جدیدی را ما ایجا آمدم مشاهده کردم که اصلا تصورش کسی نمیکرد. یعنی چه بگویم موضوع سیاسی نشه در دیگه کشورها یک کسی را اگر ببینن او را به بهانه هایی که تو مسیحی هستی یا تو فلانی چیز هستی و تو از دینی مانستی دفتن او را میکشن نمیمانن. اما برعکس در آستین یک مسجد است. اوجا ما یک سال که بودیم در آستین میرفتیم میدیدیم گاردای مسجد خود امریکایی ها است. تعجب میکردیم بودنی زندگی کردن در این تو محیط لذت بخشتر بر ما می ساخت.
What can be most concerning are the negative experiences that youth in particular face in school as a result of the overwhelmingly negative political rhetoric against outsiders.
I definitely feel that being a visually identified Muslim woman has affected my living experience in America, because when I approach people, when people see me, that's the first thing that they see. So everyone has unconscious bias, and I have to be aware of those. And being aware of those, oh my God, gives you identity crisis. Another thing that is kind of challenging for me is knowing that I am a Muslim woman and people can see that. It gives me imposter syndrome. For example, during interviews, when I try to apply for a job or an internship or a position, I keep thinking, am I getting this position just because they can see I'm a Muslim and I bring identity to this, like diversity to this job or position? So I have to keep thinking about that.
The teacher told me to answer the question. I didn't know how to speak English, so I keep quiet. And then kids laughed at me. It was very uncomfortable. And then we went to lunch on cafeteria. There was a lot of students. When I was going to get lunch, one of the students put his leg in front of me, and then I fall with the food on the floor.
When I was wearing a hijab, I feel like when people looked at me, they immediately know that I was Muslim and I was different. I feel like some people at my school, from middle school or from elementary school, like I said, treated me differently. Some people bullied me for wearing the hijab. It's the whole reason why I took it off. It got to me. People sometimes bullied me because I wore the hijab.
Okay, there was a guy, and the first week of school, he was helping me, like, you know, to figure out school, like classes. He was like, okay, let's see your schedule. What do you have next class? And I was just showing my schedule, and he was just, okay, this class is here. And I was like, okay, thank you. But after like 2-3 weeks later, he just, you know, kind of trying to change his schedule and be in class with me. And I was like, I don't like that. I was like, what is going on here? I don't want to deal with this.
I remember once I went to the library. I was looking for a book that I saw online. And because at that time I couldn't read, so I didn't know how to say the book. And there was a lot of people in the library, and they started like laughing at me. It was very uncomfortable, so I just left the library because I was very uncomfortable.
Another situation where I felt unwelcomed is while I was in high school, a person who I considered to be a friend of mine took a picture of me and put like a background of a prison, and then he titled it Bomb Threat. That's another example where I felt unwelcomed, uncomfortable. In middle school, as I was walking by the hallways, students would give me weird looks as if I was an alien. It was a lot of situations that made me uncomfortable, unwelcomed, but I can't really number all of them. I tried to block the memories from my head.
And yet, with their lives no longer at risk, refugees can slow down, breathe, and imagine a future for themselves and their families.
الحرية هنا بأمريكا ما كنا نشوفها هناك ببلادنا. بعدين هنا الشخص يعني لو حتى قديش كان عمره كبير أو صغير يقدر يدرس يقدر يشتغل يقدر يمارس هواياته بينما نفتقد هذا الشيء هناك ببلادنا.
أتي بنالي أبو يا أبو تورا مانجي توري مانجي برا باري أبو كام غارنا بايو جي غارنا بني अब गाडी कुदाउन भयो कामहरु गर्न भयो जुनै काम पनि अब त्यो छोरा मान्छे छोरी मान्छे नछुट्याउने अब सबै बराबरी एउटै सम्मान गर्ने त्यो चाहिँ एकदमै राम्रो
अनि नङामा भन सेफ फिसि मुसी रेखामाले लल्लासवा कुचेले न्यामा फक दिने छङिने लल्लासवा तोलो यारे म्यु म्यु भ खले किसा कुन दिने या तकामा
I was happy because I knew I would have a chance of becoming something greater than myself. If I would have stayed in Iraq, like obviously I would have got my education and then I probably would have been like a housewife or something at home without future or anything or a career. But I knew that when I came here, I would be treated differently. I would have an equal opportunity to pursue my dreams, to be who I want to be, to become something else.
This is how you can let them know you are listening. Go to interfaithtexas.org.